Well, here we are, day one DesignCon, rocking and rolling. Welcome, Jenna.
Thank you.
So what have you seen so far? You just got here today.
Yes, it's been a busy day. I mean, I feel like the floor has been busy. Constant conversations, constant questions, but everyone's really excited to be here, excited to see each other again.
Yeah, you should see the keynote this morning was absolutely packed. Well, it was the chair of the Division of Engineering for Mayo Clinic.
And the healthcare topics he was talking about.
He was phenomenal. We actually interviewed him here after, and okay. He was talking about the healthcare of the future, the hospital of the future. And I said, what about AI? So it's like down the road. I said, no, it's here. It's not down the road. IoT is not down the road. It's here. So he said things are really happening. So what are you expecting here?
I'm really hoping for just the conversation, right? What's on people's minds? What are they struggling with? What are they hearing at the moment? And that's what I feel like we've achieved. It's incredible, though, to see people come back together, feel that physical nature as well of kind of, let's sit down, let's have these business discussions. Let's touch things, right, on the booth. Let's touch the components on the table. I think that's been really cool.
By the way, because there were components, I went around and I just kind of grabbed some tchotchkes around, and I was looking at a chip show, what do people give out? They don't give out chips, but they give out pins. I'm talking about like a lot of pins.
A lot of pins.
But I found one company that gives out, talk about one-upmanship. Packages of pet. I may have stolen the whole thing. I don't know. Maybe they're supposed to be separate. But and candy. You can't have
candy.
I got
candy.
These for you. This is a little snack thing.
I love chocolate.
And then yesterday, what Ken and I found was the bag of tchotchke stuff. What we kept was the bag, because that was like the key thing. Today, rolling around, talk about a product placement. I actually found a much better bag. And guess where? It actually is a much, much better bag. So I've upgraded my bag. So that's kind of what I've found on the show floor. Other than looking at a lot of chips.
It's been great seeing the Omdia guys here, talking to folks about what they're facing in the market. I think had a chance to catch the semiconductor analysts today do their presentation, which is really interesting. And not just there, but throughout the day, the majority of conversation I was hearing was about automotive.
Really?
Which I was not expecting, right? But that was a lot of the questions around, I mean, of course you hear about the capacity issues with components, which the majority of folks here will face. But a lot of it's about how is automotive gonna recover and why is automotive taking a majority of the pressure in the capacity?
Interesting you say that, because one of the analysts we talked to yesterday was like basically the automotive chip shortage level, actually. And we're hearing from ARM, we talked to yesterday, same thing. They're dealing with chips right at the base level of automotive. And the coolest thing on the exhibit floor that we've seen are these two cars that are totally decked out with LiDAR and radar and cameras and everything. And they're actually, that's VSI Labs, they're actually doing research for basically best practice for connected vehicles.
Right, their cars are so cool. I can't wait to see them whip around here. I'm glad we have the wider aisles this year for that to work. But it is about that though in automotive, is AI driving a huge amount of extra demand, right? So yes, you have issues in terms of capacity because of COVID and people wanting new cars, but also you have AI adding to the demand, which is causing all of these supply problems.
And what we're hearing from Omdia yesterday, interestingly, that the car prices, because of the shortages, the prices are they're obviously going up, but they're not going to be going down, because in the automotive industry, the chip demand for other industries, the automotive industry has to pay more because they have to compete for the chips. So it's a catch-22. So if someone's going to buy a car, they probably should have already bought it.
And I think for these designers, it's difficult when you think about car production. It's not like cell phone production where a cell phone lasts for 3 years. I mean, your car has to last for 10 years.
Right.
So one of the questions we were getting today is efficiency. So when you're talking about design, you're not only having to improve efficiency, improve the AI capability, improve the connectivity in the car. You have to make it last for 10 years when AI and IoT is moving so fast. That was a lot of the challenges as we were talking around today.
So what are you expecting to see in the next day?
I'm really interested to see how the vendors and the chip guys are coming together to solve those problems, right? And I think we've heard some of those folks, like you talked about with ARM and automotive and what they're doing there to help the industry. but also to understand, are there other industries? I mean, we heard healthcare today. Is that an industry a big concern? And I think I kind of am wondering if a lot of what we're hearing in automotive isn't also applicable to healthcare. So I'm curious now that we've seen Mayo Clinic talk and kind of the conversation now will change a little bit with folks tomorrow if we start to see that come out more.
Well, I can hardly wait for tomorrow.
It's exciting.
So we'll watch for it.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much, Chuck.